Hi children, welcome back. In previous session we have learned tests of divisibility from 1 to 11. Now in this part we will be seeing the forward rules for next numbers and how we are going to solve the rules for that. Children, general notes for us. A number is divisible by another number if it is also divisible by its co-prime factors. Co-prime factors means the numbers which are having only one as its multiple and a common number. So the co-prime factors of 50 are 3 and 5. So a 3 and 5 is only having one common number, that is one common multiple, that is 1. 3 into 1 and 5 into 1. In any other table we will not find 3 and 5. Now next, a number is divisible by 12 if it is divisible by co-prime factors of 12, that is 3 and 4. In 12 table is having many number of multiples, that is 2, 6, and you can see 3 and 4, 12. But here 3 and 4 are not having any relation with any other table. They are only related in one table, that is 1. So 3 and 4 are the co-prime numbers, co-prime factors for 12. That's why the given number is divisible by 3 and 4. Divisibility rule for 15. If it is divisible by co-prime factors of 15, that is 3 and 5. If the given number is divisible by 3 and then 5, then it is also divisible by 15. If any number, you know, divisibility rule for 3, you have to add all the numbers and check whether it is divisible by 3 or not. For 5, the units place must be 0 and 5. Next, coming to 18. If it is divisible by co-prime factors of 18, that is 2 and 9. If the given number is divisible by 2 and 9, then it is also divisible by 8. 2, divisibility rule for 2 is the last units place must be multiple of 2, and for 9 it is same as 3. Add all the numbers and check whether it is divisible by 9 or not. Now we have to check 45. If it is divisible by co-prime factors of 45, that is 9 and 5. So 9 and 5 is having only one common number, that is 1. No other table will be entered in this. So these are called the co-prime factors of 45. If the given number is divisible by both 9 and 5, divisibility rule for 9, it is add all the numbers and check the product which you got is divisible by 9 or not. And for the divisibility rule for 5 is units place must be 0 or 5. Now general rules of divisibility for all numbers, not for only 1 to 11 or random numbers. Now we are seeing general rules for divisibility. If a number is divisible by another number, then it is also divisible by all factors of the other number. If two numbers are divisible by another number, their sum and difference is also divisible by the number. If a number is divisible by two co-prime numbers, then it is also divisible by the product of the two co-prime numbers. Understood? A number is divisible by another number is also divisible by the factors. Factors means two different tables. Second one, if two numbers are divisible by another number, two numbers, it is divisible by another number. Their sum and difference is also, sum means addition, difference means subtraction. That two numbers also divisible by the given number. If a number is divisible by two co-prime numbers, then it is also divisible by the product of two co-prime numbers. For suppose two co-prime numbers, 3 and 5 I am taking. When you are multiplying 3 and 5, what you are getting the product? 15. So when two co-prime numbers are multiplied, the answer what you got, that is also a divisible of the given number. Divisibility rules for 1 through 20. Till 20 I have given the divisibility rules. If you see here divisible by 2, what is the test you have to do? You have to see the digits are in even or not. You see the digits here, last digit is 6, so it is divisible by 2, right? Now third rule, whatever we have seen in our picture imagination, same rules are following here also. 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5 are there in this table. 2 means last digit should be the multiple of 2. For 3, what you have to do? You have to add all the numbers in the given number. All the digits in the given number. This is my number. When I am adding all together, I am getting 69. And when you are adding 69 again, you are getting 15. 15 is the multiple of 3. So it is the divisibility rule for 3. Coming to 4, what you have to do? You have to check last two digits. What are my last two digits here? 12. So 12 is the multiple of 4. So this is also divisibility rule for 4. If you check, 10th digit is 1, odds and ones digit is 2. So this is divisible by 4. What is divisibility for 5? It is easy for you. If the last digit is 0 or 5, it is divisible by 5. Now here we are having divisibility rules for 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And what is the test you have to observe? It was written clearly in this box. Read that box so that you will be having a clear cut idea to what you have to do for the divisibility rules for 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. For divisibility rule for 6, 2 and 3 should be there. Divisibility rule for 7, as I told, double the number and then add it and multiply it by 12. But suppose here 357. Double 7, last digit. What is your double of 7? It is 14. Subtract 14 from 35. Your starting number is 35. From that, the number what you have doubled, it is 14. You do subtraction. That is 14. 35 minus 14, you are getting 21. 21 is multiple of 7. This is the easiest way to find out your test of 7. Now, for 8. For 8, what you have to do? You have to check out the place values, evens and odds. You have to add and then you have to check out. 100 digits even, last 2 digits divisible by 8. 100 digits odd, add 4 to last 2 digits and sum of the divisibles by 8. Last 8 digits divisible by 8. There are 2 rules here. You can go through whichever rule you want. 104 if you are taking. See whether 104 is born in 8 table or not. Means divisible in 8 table or not. If you check, if your answer is divisible in 8, then it is divisible by 8. Coming to 9, add the total number of digits in the given number. If it is divisible by 9 or multiple of 9, then it is divisible by 9. For 10, easily you can remember, the last unit's place must be 0. If it is 0, it is the divisibility rule for 10. Now coming to our forward rules, that is 11, 12, 13 and 14. For 11, I told you have to add the alternate numbers and you have to see the difference whether it is 11 multiple or it is 0. Then you will be telling the given number is divisible by 11. Now divisibility rule for 12. For divisibility rule of 12, you have to check whether the given number is divisible in 3 or 4. For 3, what is the rule? Add together. And for 4, you have to check the last 2 digits and divisible by 4 or not, you have to check. For 13, alternatively add 4 times the last digit to the rest. What is your 7 here? 63 plus 7 into 4, that is equal to 91. 9 plus 1 into 4, that is equal to 13. 63 plus 7 into 4. When you are adding the 7 into 4 with the 63, you are getting 91. For this 9, again you have to add 1 for 4 times. You will be getting 13. Normally divisibility rule for 13, in most of the cases you may not get. Now 14, you are not having any rule for that. You just check out whether the given number is divisible by 2 and 7 or not. Divisibility rule for 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 25 and 50. Here the test of rules are given, children. You go through that, it will be easy for you to solve the solution. For 15, 3 and 5 are the tables to check out. For 16, see here, 1000 digits are 4, so take 176. Here my 1000 is 4, so take last 3 digits. What you have to do, you have to multiply 1 with 4 and plus you have to add 76. 1 means because it is in hundreds place, you multiply 1 into 4000 plus 76. What is your answer? 80 is multiple of 5, so the given number is multiple by 16. Now, here also, what is 1000 here? 3. What are your last digits? 4, not 8. So, 4 should be multiplied by 4 and add. We are getting 32. 32 is a multiple of 16. So, the given numbers are divisibility rule for 16. 17, subtract. 18, you have to check 2 and 9. 19, add twice the last digit to the rest. 7 is last digit. Add it for 2 times means multiply it for 2 times and then add. Check whether it is divisible in 19 or not. For 20, last digit should be 0 and even numbers. Now, 25, last digit should be 5 and 0. For 50, last digit should be 0 means the unit space, large digit is nothing but unit space. This is how you are going to check out your rest of divisibility rules till 50. You can go through the table carefully, Nana, and you can learn. If you get any doubts, you practice once. Even though you get any doubt, get back to me. Now children, it is your turn. Use divisibility test to find which of the following numbers are divisible by 12, by 15 and by 18. I have given simple numbers. Go through the numbers and do your divisibility rules for 12, 15 and 18. Practice well all the divisibility rules. Get back to me if you are having any doubts. Thank you. Hari Om.